Guys, thank you so much for tuning back in for another video. Today, we're going to be answering one of the questions that I get asked quite often, and that would be, how exactly did you black out your headlight amber turn sensors? As you can see, if you look at a stock Jeep, there is a huge, huge amber marker right there. And if you're kind of going for like a blacked out theme, or you just don't want it to be, it just looks super obnoxious and gaudy. And it was actually the first mod that I ever did to this Jeep because I thought it made such a big difference on other people's Jeeps. So I'm going to talk about how I did mine, and then I'm going to talk to you about how I recommend you do yours. So there's a company way back in the day, this was probably maybe 6 years ago, called Stillin, and they used to make headlight covers for the 2005 to 2007 Jeeps and then the 2008 to 2010 Jeeps. So they used to be pretty much the only way to go if you were going to black out your headlights. They didn't really offer internally blacked out headlights at the time. And then there really wasn't any other proven options to do to black them out. So what I ended up going with was the Stillin covers because I didn't really know any better or know what else to do. And so these are basically large plastic pieces that have double-sided tape on them. And they kind of just fit and cover up everything. So this obviously isn't a bad option. It definitely does the job. No light will ever shine through that. But it was difficult to do and it was expensive. I believe they were about $120 to buy them. They came as raw plastic, so you had to paint them, which I guess is kind of convenient because you could paint them whatever color you wanted to. But if you're going blacked out, the black plastic, just the natural color didn't look good. So it was difficult. I definitely asked as many people as I possibly could in the realm of Jeep Grand Cherokees to get help, and they really didn't have any other options besides this. Now, as time has passed, there are definitely some other options, and I'm gonna lead you onto those options because I think they are way better than the way that I went. So, one option that you can do is you can find blacked out headlights where the side marker is blacked out as well. So it's either clear, a clear color, just like the rest of this is up here. So it lights up amber, but it's a clear color, which is like the best way to go because it is actually legal. It will actually flash like it's supposed to because there is a bulb behind that piece of plastic that is a turn signal flashing. For those of you who have never really inspected your headlights, somewhere about here, there's a bulb that flashes and it kind of lights up all of the amber. And then as well, you have a regular turn signal bulb down here, if you can see that. And that lights up amber as well. So this is kind of like the half illegal version. The best, absolute best version would be to replace your headlights with some aftermarket ones. You can find them on eBay for anywhere between $100 to $200 for blacked out aftermarket headlights. For those wondering, these headlights are blacked out headlights, but they did not include, I didn't know that there was even the option to get headlights where they didn't have the amber on the side. So after I ordered them and installed them, I went looking again and found that they did have that option. So I was pretty salty to realize that. But now that I know, I can tell you guys that that is probably the best option to go. There's only three bolts holding the headlight on. You need to take the grill off and the front bumper if you really want to make it easier on yourself. Unfortunately, I've already installed the headlights, so I can't really do a video explaining how to do them. But that would be the number one option. Number two option would be, and if I was gonna do this a second time on my stock Jeep, this is what I would do, is that I would just use black, gloss black vinyl, and I would just cover it up. So what you can do is you can get knifeless tape, and you can put the tape here, and then just stretch the gloss black vinyl over all of it, and kind of wrap it around the edges, and then use the knifeless tape to get a nice clean line. I know other people who've done that, and the best idea would be to do more than one layer of the gloss black vinyl, because I believe with one layer of gloss black vinyl, it's still the amber light shines through it. But if you do two, it's the amber light still shines through a little bit, but it just shows up more as light and there's really no amber to it. So In hindsight, doing it the first time around, that's what I would have went with. But if I was going to replace my headlights anyways, which I think these headlights look 1,000 times better than the stock factory headlights. So it's kind of up to you. Those are the three best options. But the still-in headlight covers that I have now, they pretty much didn't make them when I bought them many years ago. So I highly doubt that they make them. I don't even know if the company's in business still, to be honest. So those are the two best options to go with. Replace your headlights where the side markers are clear and they use a clear light that flashes amber. That'd be number one. And then number two would be gloss black vinyl over the edge with multiple layers and then using knifeless tape. You could even take it to like a vinyl place and they'd probably charge you like $40, $50 to do it. So it wouldn't be a super difficult process. I hope those of you who had the questions that I constantly get asked learned something from this video. If you did, make sure to leave a like, subscribe to the channel so I can keep bringing you guys more content about Jeep Grand Cherokees and help expanding everyone's knowledge on YouTube. So thank you very much. Again, subscribe. It really helps the channel grow. And I will catch you guys in the next video.